So comparison of numbers, that is, so from the lower class we are learning this, yes or no? Yes. So comparing numbers with unequal number of digits. So unequal in sense, see both the sides, just see how many digits are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And this side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just I have written the place value also for your reference. Clear ma? So now see, so which side we will be putting that greater than symbol? Yes, the number which is in the, which has more digits. Yes or no? Yes. So next is comparing numbers with equal number of digits. Comparing numbers with equal number of digits. Okay ma? So now see here. 2180, that is 2180 and 2158. Clear ma? Okay. So here both the sides it has 4 digits. Yes or no? Both the sides it has 4 digits. So what we have to see? So what we have to see is, so first we have to compare the thousands place. First we have to compare the thousands place of two numbers. So in both the numbers, what is the thing? What we can able to guess? So in the thousands place, both the numbers are same. Okay. Then move for the hundredth place. Okay, ma'am. So here also one, and in this number also the number is one. So next move to the 10th place. Okay, so here it is different. If here also it is same, inge 8 arundhuchna, then we should go for the 1st place. Clear ma? So 8, 5. So comparing to this, so which is the bigger number now? Yes, 2180. Yes or no? So we have to turn the symbol like this. Yes or no? Yes. Next, we are going to learn about the arranging, that is ascending and descending order. Arranging the numbers in ascending and descending order. So for example, they have given a some heights. Okay, well, that is 985 feet, 1145 feet, 1865 feet, and 355 and 585 feet. Yes or no? Yes. So now they have arranged that also according to their heights. Is it possible for us to arrange in ascending and descending order? Yes. Yes. So what is ascending order? What is ascending order, ma'am? Yes. Arranging the numbers from small one to big one. Arranging the numbers from small one to big one. So apartment ABC. So they have written the things in the tabular column. They have written the things in the tabular column, that is A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so the towers. Then they have written the numbers also. So first thing, we have to compare the digits. So see here, only two things it is in 4 digits and remaining all it is following the 3 digits number. Yes or no? So comparing to all these, which is the tallest apartment? Which is the tallest apartment? Yes. Apartment C. Then second tallest is apartment B. Yes or no? Yes. So next, compare the numbers in the 100th place. So 100th place in sense, which is the biggest number now? Yes, it is 9, then 5 and 3. Yes or no? Yes. So arranging the numbers in ascending and descending order in sense, so from small number to big number. From small number to big number. Yes or no? So which will be the smallest number in that? 355, then 585, 985, 1245 and 1865. Yes or no? Yes. So the same thing, if we are moving for descending order, we will be writing from the big number to small number. Big number to small number. Clear ma? Yes. So creating new numbers. Next topic is creating new numbers. So creating new numbers in sense, they have given some digits, that is 9, 4, 8 and 5. 9, 4, 8 and 5. Okay. So we have to make this in different four digits number so that only they have arranged. So 904, 9485, 58, 45, 54 and 48, 84. Okay, but they have kept the thousands place as such and remaining 100, tens and ones they have changed and written. Clear? So this is how forming the new numbers. Isma? Yes. So the next one is impact of place value. Impact of place value. So place value is nothing but Okay. So place value in sense, for example, 5435. So what is the place value of 4? What is the place value of 4? It will be the question. Okay, what we have to say? Yes. So it is in which place? Ones, tens, hundreds. And it is, the 4 is in the 100th place. It is in the 100th place. So 4 into 100, which is equal to 400. This is the way how we have to write the place value. Clear, ma? So see this, ma. So in an exam in exhibition, the number of tickets sold on the 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th days are 10,000, 75, 1,060, 25,700, and 30,606. So this is the thing way we are going to see how we are adding big numbers, okay, well, large numbers in our daily life. Okay, well, so first day they have sold 1,10,000 and second day they have sold 75,060 and third day they are selling 25,700 and fourth day 30,606. So if you are adding total, so the total will be, so first we have to add the ones place, then tens, hundreds, thousands and ten thousands and lakhs. So the answer will be 2,41,366. So this is some examples for us to learn how we are using the large numbers in our daily life. Yes, ma? So order of operations. So order of operation in sense, in which order we have to order. Okay, well, now here that they have given an example that, so one Valli and her four friends is going to Buttermilk and they are buying some things. Okay, well, so Valli is calculating as 5 into 6 plus 2 and the shopkeeper is calculating as 5 into 6 plus 2. Okay, so the answer is differing. So Valli, she is saying that it is 32 rupees and the shopkeeper, he is saying that it is 40 rupees. Now see, there are some order in the max, how we have to operate it. So see here, so that is called as bit mass. Okay, well, bit mass. So first we have to do bit mass in sense B is bracket and I indices, D division, M multiplication, D addition and A addition and S is subtraction. So first if there is any bracket, we have to do the operation which is in the bracket, then we have to move for indices. This we will be learning it later. Next, division, multiplication, addition and final we have to subtract the things. Yes, ma? Yes. Now see, there is an example. So first, that is 9 plus 5 into 2. So according to the bit mass, first we have to multiply the things. That is 5 plus 5 into 9 plus 5 into 2, which is equal to 9. And what is 5 plus 2? It is 10. Then they have added the sum. Yes? Okay. Let us see one more example by using that bit mass. Okay. So B is bracket, I is indices and D division, M, A and S. M is multiplication, A addition and subtraction. Okay, ma'am. So now 24 plus 2. So first see in this sum whether there is bracket. So here there is no bracket. Next we are going to for indices. So there is no indices. Indices we will be learning it later. Next, division. So is there any division? Yes. So 8 divided by 2. So write the remaining numbers as such. 24 plus 2 into, so 8 divided by 2 in sense it will be 4 and minus 1. So next what we are going to do? Yes. Next we have to see whether any multiplication is there.
Is there multiplication now? Yes, 2 into 4. That is 24 plus 2 into 4 is 8 minus 1. Next, we will be doing the addition. Yes, yes. Now see 24 plus 8. What is 24 plus 8? It will be 32 and minus 1, which is equal to 31. Yes, ma'am. So remember, so this will be helpful in all the problems. Till now, till your higher class, you will be, it will be very useful, this bit mass. Okay, ma'am. So whenever we are doing, we are solving, we are simplifying the problems, first we have to check whether bracket is there. Next, division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Clear, ma'am?
So the next one is estimation of numbers. So estimation of numbers, in sense, we can't count how many people approximately in a crowd. Yes or no? So instead of that, we will be saying just there may be 10,000 people, there may be 1,000 people. Yes or no? So that is called as estimating of numbers. That is called as estimation of numbers. So see here, there are some examples. Nearly 60,000 people watched the Republic Day Parade at Rajpath in Delhi. Next, in tsunami, nearly 2,80,000 people, they have died. Yes or no? Yes. So they are not saying the approximate value, how many they died, how many people they watched the Republic Day. They didn't say approximately. They have just said this much of people they may be. Fine, ma'am? So the next is rounding off. So rounding off is nothing but for quick calculation. Okay, in simple way we can say it is a quick calculation. Okay, ma'am. So see here, round off 8,436 to nearest hundreds. Yes, yes. So see the first step. So find the digits in hundreds place. So just see what is the number in hundreds place. Yes, can anybody say what is that number? Yes, it is 4. Next, we have to check whether it is in, look at the digit towards right. Okay, ma'am. So next we have to say, see what is the number in the next place. If this digit is 5 or greater, then add 1 to it. Okay, ma'am. So see here, 4 is lesser than 5 or greater than 5. Yes, it is lesser than 5. So we are calculating it to the nearest 100, that is 8,400. Now for your clear explanation, I have drawn the number line and I am going to clear you. That is, the number is 8,436. So we have to see in between which two numbers this hundreds lies. That means it lies between 8,400 to 8,500. Yes or no? Yes. So you just write it 8,400, next 8,410, 8,420, 430, that is 8,430, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 8,500. Okay, ma'am. Now, so see here, it is 8,436. So where it lies, it will be lying between this 8,430 and 8,440. Yes or no? In between these two numbers only, it will be coming. Am I right? So one more thing is, we have to see if the number is greater than or lesser than. Okay, why? If it lies, see the midpoint will be always 5. The midpoint will be always 5. So here this 8,436, it is this side. That is, it is lesser than 8,440. So we have to write, this is closer to 8,436 is closer to 8,400. Clear, ma'am? Yes. So next one is, so like the same thing they have given for the estimation of sum and the difference. Okay, wow. So first we have to round off the numbers, then we have to do the further steps, then we have to find the difference between that numbers. The same thing for estimation of product and quotient. Okay, wow. See here they have given 189. So 189, in sense, it is nearer to 200 and 31 is nearer to 30. Yes or no? Yes. So the exact cost of 31 copies is this much. But for approximately, if you are saying, it will be 200, that is 6000. It is round off to 6000, we will be saying. Okay, ma'am? Yes. Now, find the estimated value of this division. So, this we have to first round off. So, round off na in sense 5600. Yes or no? Yes. So, next is 689. If you are rounding off na 89 in sense, it is greater than 50. So, we are rounded to 700. Then we have to do the division. Yes, ma'am? Okay. Now, do that exercise. What is in your exercise 1.4? So, next is the whole numbers and natural numbers. Okay, wow. So, whole numbers in sense, it will be started from 0 to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and etc. That is called as whole numbers. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is called as natural numbers. So, this natural numbers always lies like this. Okay, wow. So, whole numbers will be included in natural numbers. Whole numbers will be included always with the natural numbers. Now, see some properties of whole numbers. So, the first one is commutative of addition and multiplication. Commutative of addition and multiplication. So, it is nothing but though we are changing the order, that is A plus B will be always equal to B plus A. For example, A I am taking 5, B as 3. So, 5 plus 3 which is equal to 3 plus 5. Though we are changing the order, the answer will be same. This is called as commutative of addition. Okay. So, next if you are taking for multiplication with the same value, 5 into 3 which is equal to 3 into 5 which is equal to 15. Yes, 5 into 3 is also 15. 3 into 5 also 15. Okay, ma. So, the product will... So, though we are changing the order, the answer will remain same. Okay. So, next is associative of addition and multiplication. So, see here. A plus B plus C which is equal to A plus B plus C. The same thing, but the bracket alone we have changed. Okay, ma. So, see here in this also. So, the same value we can take. A is equal to 3. B is equal to 2 and C is equal to 4. Okay. So, what is the value of A now? Let us do first for addition. Okay. So, 3 plus 2 plus 4 which is equal to 3 plus within the bracket. Okay. That is 2 plus 4. So, first we have to do the things what is inside the bracket. Okay, what is inside the bracket? Yes or no? Bit mass. Yes. So, 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 plus 4 which is equal to 3 plus 6. Okay. So, what is 5 plus 4 now? 9 which is equal to 9. So, this is associative property. So, here the brackets they have changed. Clear, ma? So, next we can take for multiplication. Multiplication in sense 3 into 2 into 4 which is equal to 3 into inside the bracket we have to write 2 into 4. Clear, ma? Yes. So, what is 3 into 2 now? Yes, 6. 6 into 4 which is equal to 3 into 2. 2 into 4 is 8. So, now what is 6 into 4? 6 into 4 is 28 and this side also 28. So, the brackets alone they have changed. Clear, ma? So, this is associative of addition and multiplication. Okay. So, now distributive of multiplication. So, distributive in sense, for example, if you are taking there is a birthday baby in our class. Okay, well, there is a birthday baby in our class. She is going to give a chocolate to the person, that is both the boys and girls. First she is giving to the boys, then she is going to give for girls. That is A into B and B into C. So, what is the symbol in between this? Addition. So, that symbol we are going to write like this. Okay, ma? If it is minus A into B minus b into, sorry, here also a. So a is distributing. Okay, wow. So a is distributing. So a into b and a into c. Here also a into b and a into c. Okay, so this is distributive of multiplication over addition and subtraction. So in between what symbol is there, we have to write the symbol. If it is plus, we have to write plus. If it is minus, we have to write minus. Okay, ma'am. So next is identify for addition and multiplication. So we know that from the lower class we are adding, we are doing addition and subtraction. Am I right? Yes. So when zero is added to any number, we get the same number. Yes or no? For example, 4 plus 0 is also equal to 4. 44,000 something plus 0 is also equal to the same number. Okay. So when we multiply any number by 1, okay, by 1 we get the same number. Yes. So 0 is called as, so 0 is called as additive identity and 1 is called as multiplicative identity. Clear, ma? So why? So whenever we are adding 0 to any number, we will be getting the same number. If we are multiplying the number with 1, we will be getting the same number. Fine. So now this is the example for that. Okay, wow. Identify for addition and multiplication. So when 0 is added, we get the same number. When we are multiplying any number by 1, we get the same number. Okay, wow. So it is called as additive identity and multiplicative identity. See in this tabular column, they have explained. Then some more observation that are important. When we add any two natural numbers, okay, wow. So the answer will be also the natural numbers. Okay, well, if we are multiplying two natural numbers also, we get a natural number. When we add two whole numbers or when we multiply any two numbers, the answer will be the whole number. So when we add, okay, well, when we add a natural number to a whole number, we get a natural number, and we multiply a natural number by a whole number, we get a whole number. So ipo enna solranga na natural number to whole number. If we are adding natural number to whole number, we will be getting natural number. If you are multiplying natural number by a whole number will be the answer. So any number multiplied by 0 gives 0. If you are multiplying the number with 0, answer will be 0. And for division, 0 is not defined. Okay, ma? See some more examples they have given. So now practice this exercise which is given in your book. Thank you.
So students, I hope you might have understood the lesson what we have seen in this video. In the next class, we will be meeting you in the next topic.